Today's obituaries are brought to you by Moss Service and Hansville Funeral Home. Funeral services for Benny C. Johnson, age 80, of Vinemont, formerly of Somerville, will be at 2 p.m. tomorrow at Shiloh Baptist Church. The Reverend Larry Duke officiating burial in Shiloh Cemetery. The body will lie in state 1 hour prior to services at the church. Peck Funeral Home Hartzell is directing. Mr. Johnson passed away on Tuesday at his residence. Visitation will be 6 to 9 p.m. tonight at the funeral home. Funeral services for Paul David Presto will be at 11 a.m. tomorrow at St. Andrew's United Methodist Church. The Reverends Walter Cash, Lee Witherington, and Jonathan Todd will officiate. Interment in Coleman City Cemetery. The body will lie in state 10 to 11 a.m. at the church. Coleman Heritage is directing. Funeral services for Audrey Nadine Thomas, age 72, of Falkville, will be at 11 a.m. tomorrow at Moss Service Funeral Home Chapel. Burial in Mount Zion Cemetery. Moss Service is directing. Ms. Thomas passed away on Tuesday. Visitation will be from 9 to 11 a.m. on Friday. Funeral services for Grover C. Cadle, age 98, of Coleman, will be at 2 p.m. tomorrow at Moss Service Funeral Home Chapel. Chad Kennedy officiating. Interment in Flint Creek Cemetery. Moss Service directing. Mr. Cadle passed away on Tuesday in Vinemont. Graveside services for Gary Audrin Despain, age 62, of Osage Beach, Missouri, will be at 11 a.m. on Saturday at Coleman City Cemetery. Hodges Scott Funeral Home in Cadenton, Missouri, is directing. Mr. Despain died Tuesday. And those are our obituaries for today, brought to you by Moss Service and Hansville Funeral Home.
Today on 2, it is Thursday, the 29th day of November. Wow, almost the end of the month.
I cannot believe it has gone by so quickly.
Goodness, December starts this weekend.
Have you started
already.
Your Christmas shopping yet, Dennis?
Oh, goodness gracious, no. We'll do that on the 24th.
The 24th? That is way too close.
Oh, no. That's the best day.
Miss Kim will get on to
you. Christmas shopping. No, it's the. Just think about this. When you go shopping on the 24th of December, the selection is very small. It's not hard to make decisions.
Easy choices. Yeah. Easy choices on that day.
One or two things on the shelf. It's easy to decide that way.
Well, there you go.
And nearly everything is on sale.
No one else needs to follow Dennis's example. I suggest that you go Christmas shopping early.
Do it my way. Takes a lot of the stress and anxiety out of it. Well, let's start with the weather for today. Our weather forecast brought to you by Mitch Smith Chevrolet on Cherokee Avenue. Make the switch to Mitch. Here's the weather almanac for the 29th of November. The average high temperature is 60. The average low is 33. The record high, 77, set in 1998. The record low is 17 in 1955. Sunrise this morning will occur in about 2 more minutes. Sunset this afternoon at 4:37. There's the satellite picture, and all that blue and white stuff up north can stay up north.
Yes.
And our part of the country looks like pretty much fair skies. Here's our forecast for today. Sunny today, high near 61. That's about as normal as you're going to get. Clear tonight, low of 37. Sunny tomorrow, again, a high of 61. But boy, look at the weekend. 68 on Saturday, 67 Sunday. Monday, 70 degrees. Wow. Beautiful weather coming for the next several days as we head into December.
Yes.
Paige is the midnight shopper.
Yes. Yes, I was. I went Black Friday shopping. I did.
We talked about this last week, and mm-hmm. you actually did.
I did go Black Friday shopping. Yes. Usually my family and I make it a little tradition to all go together. But it's gotten so big this year. It really has. It was just too big for me. I went to Belk, and then I went home. I was done after that. That was just, it's so many people come, and they open so much earlier, and people are much angrier. They want more things.
Okay, now Belk opened at what time?
They opened at 12 o'clock.
At 12 o'clock. Mm-hmm. And did you get in line early?
My parents actually tried to get in line early. I didn't brave that crowd. Because a couple of years ago, I don't remember, we were in line. This was when Black Friday was sort of smaller. So me and Mom had gotten in line. That's when they opened at about 5. So we got in line at about 3 o'clock. And we were one of the first people there. This was our first Black Friday to go shopping, so we really didn't know what to expect. Well, we hear this thump in the parking lot of Belk. Someone had hit a pedestrian with their vehicle. Someone had hit someone in the parking lot of Belk.
At like 5 in the morning?
Like 3, 4 o'clock in the morning. And I mean, she was very nice about it. She just kind of limped away. And was kind. She was like, the lady got out and checked to see if she was okay. And she's like, it's fine. And they went about their business.
We have important things to do. We're going shopping.
We're going shopping. So, it's a little hectic.
The crowd was bigger this year?
The crowd was much bigger than it's ever been.
I wonder if that's because of opening at midnight is easier than at 5 in the morning or not?
I guess so. I guess it would be easier on the employees, too, maybe.
Well, maybe so. But I just wondered if it's more convenient for shoppers or are more people aware.
But something my brother said at Thanksgiving, he said, now we're all going to sit around the table today and we're going to be very thankful for what we have. And then we're going to go fight people tonight at 12 o'clock to go shopping. And I was like, oh, that makes me feel a little bad. Makes me feel a little sting in my heart.
I take it Wade is not a Black Friday shopper.
He has never been a Black Friday shopper, but he did go Black Friday shopping with us this year.
Oh, we did.
I was shocked because I met my family there, and Wade was in line with them. And I said, Wade, what are you doing here? He said, I have to buy my girlfriend something for Christmas.
Well, okay, for making the effort to get there at midnight, did you get some bargains?
Yes, we did get good bargains. We did. My mother got a lot of good Christmas shopping done. So
it was worth it?
It was worth it.
All right.
It was worth it.
Okay. Let's check our Facebook friend of the day. Who's our friend today?
Yes, our Facebook friend of the day today is Lyric Zach, and she likes Mitt Romney and Facebook. And thank you, Lyric, for being our Facebook friend. If you would like to friend us on Facebook, audience, you can do that. Friend us on Facebook. We're Channel 2 Coleman, and perhaps you'll be our Facebook friend of the day.
And who's coming to see us today? You have a friend coming to see us today.
Yes, I'm so excited because we get to introduce the newly crowned Miss Coleman area. Her name is Kelsey Richter, and she and I competed in the 2010 Miss Alabama competition, and we are all very lucky here in Coleman to have Kelsey represent us. She is just a wonderful girl, very talented, and you'll get to speak with her in just a few moments. And also we have Miss Sally Alexander. She's going to come and talk about the Christmas parade that's coming up this weekend, mm-hmm. so we're all very excited to hear about that.
And Sally is a friend also has been on our program several times, usually to talk about the Christmas parade in Hanceville, so we expect Sally here today. George Spear is here with news and commentary right after this.
Cheyenne, Cheyenne, where will you be camping tonight? Lonely man, Cheyenne, will your heart stay free and light? Dream, Cheyenne, of a girl you may never love. Move along, Cheyenne, like a restless cloud up above.
Fire, accident, storm,
They all happen in Coleman County. And for three generations, Knight Free Insurance has been there for you. Continuing today with Elliott and Westcott Free, customizing your life, home, auto, and business insurance with auto owners. Call Westcott, Elliott, Judy, Tina, Angie, or Karen. Knight Free Insurance, where people are the difference.
In the nation, we can't make every annoying thing disappear, but we can eliminate deductibles. Nationwide insurance members who add vanishing deductible get $100 off for every year of safe driving. Join the nation where deductibles go.
Nationwide is on your side.
Time for news and commentary. If you have an opinion or something to add to what we're talking about this morning, something happening out there, you let us know. Give us a call at that phone number. Don't forget, we are streaming live, channel2coleman.com. Well, it looks like the papers, the news this morning, it's almost like a tempest in a teapot when you keep mentioning the North Alabama Regional Council of Governments, NARCOG. That seems to stay in the news, and this is certainly no different, this morning's edition of the papers. I guess our governor, who has been asked to get involved, says, look, y'all handle this. You know, come on, counties. Can't you figure out something to make things work? And I don't blame him in that regard, because it puts a governor in a tough position, you know, whenever you have to make those kind of decisions. Well, we've talked about for the past several days about the bank robber who appeared about to try to rob Traditions Bank on Highway 31 here in Coleman. And now it seems as though that the Coleman Police Department, according to the news story this morning, say they think they know who the person is, an individual who has robbed several banks, some of them Traditions, maybe it might have been a Regions Bank at one point, but they believe they know the identity of the individual concerned, so maybe they can find this individual. I don't know. To me, it seems as though that if you're going to try to prepare your employees, your bank tellers and such, I'm not sure how you'd go about that other than just actually do it. And that's what police have done in Priceville, believe it or not. Bank officials, sheriff investigators in Morgan County teaming up to show the employees of the bank tellers, you know, have someone actually going in and trying to, well, not really rob the bank, but they're trying to make them aware that they need to be aware of their surroundings. And that's probably the biggest thing you can do, or one of the most important things, is know what's going on around you, because it's so often that people sort of tune everything out except what they're doing in their own little field of vision, and I guess I'm guilty of doing the same thing. The bit of maintenance news inside the Coleman City here, the street department for Coleman reports that the power board is going to close off 4th Street Southeast between 3rd and 2nd Avenues. They're going to be building some trench work there. So for those of you living in that area, heads up, because you'll have that closed off. The board that oversees Alabama's prepaid college tuition reports that things are not looking any better. In fact, they're getting worse, it appears. More bad news about their financial condition. The board, who Dan Sherman is one of the members, says that the board's liabilities will exceed its assets by $605 million if it keeps paying full tuition for students, which is what, you know, parents were sold on going with this program. If they continue the way they're going now, it should be out of money in the fall of 2015. And there are a lot of parents upset about that issue. I don't know if it was mismanagement or what, but at any rate, prepaid tuition may be one of the most endangered species, in America right now, because it keeps increasing, tuition does. Mississippi casinos actually had the worst revenue month since September of 98. That's talking about October last month. The worst one, gamblers losing 8% less than in October 2011. In the military, used to, don't know that it still exists, but overseas, at least in the Orient, You had in some of the military clubs these one-armed bandits. And I was talking to a club manager one time about these things. And if, as you well know, you can adjust the frequency of winds on those machines so that it pays out more or pays out less. No explanation regarding this story about these casinos in Mississippi. But there are 17 river casinos from Tunica to Natchez. Won $83.9 million. That was down 11% from the $93.9 million that they won last year. Wow. I don't know how much you have to win. You know, I mean, that's a lot of money. And, of course, I haven't seen any efforts in recent months or the past couple of years to go the gambling route. Every time that comes up on the ballot, it's voted down, basically. But, you know, all you have to do is drive 69 into Jasper. And look at all those places that are closed. Man, somebody took a bath, didn't they? You know, or some folks did for the short time that they were open. And don't think that's going to be something we see at least too soon here. Folks in DeKalb County, law enforcement, telling their residents in DeKalb, be careful because there's a scam underway. Salesman trying to sell you laundry detergent that you can buy off the shelf. But in actuality, what they're doing is when they get in the door, they look and see what you've got, big screen TVs, all kinds of things that later they will try to take from you. Again, this happened before in Cullman County. It happened to me once. I wasn't aware that the person was doing what he was doing, but he wanted to sell me some little cleaning agent or something like that. And he kept wanting to come into my living room. And I said, no, I'm not interested, period. So that sort of thing is quite common when it comes to people who are up to no good. I don't know if you heard this story or not, but yesterday morning, down at the funeral parlor, their incinerator didn't work right. Had a fire on top of their roof down there in Birmingham. And you could see the person going up in smoke, literally. It's just a sad situation whenever things don't work right, and you've got that. I know outside the Marine Corps Air Station Iwakuni, where I was stationed back in the late 80s, there was an incinerator that went 24/7. That's the way a lot of the Japanese, their remains were taken care of, is using an incinerator. We always had a saying around Iwakuni that you always had to just breathe dead people, basically, is what it amounted to. The air sometimes would be thick with that. Just a terrible situation. But, of course, no one's going to admit that it's not really good for you to breathe that smoke. But that's basically what happened. A deputy sheriff in Canadian County, Oklahoma, stopping an SUV because they were following too close to another individual. And the police started unloading the vehicle. And there were 14, that's 14 illegal immigrants packed inside this SUV. How did the tires stay up on that thing when you think about it? So it's just amazing to me. But those folks want a good life, and they certainly aren't getting it south of the border down Mexico way, are they? At least it doesn't appear that way. This is something that always is a problem for the news media, and that is that when someone, especially now with news on the web, people doing twitting, you know, you can follow like the Cullman Times, you can follow other media outlets on the internet, Twitter and such as that, Facebook. Well, they decided to believe a story that was written by a somewhat reputable web page individual, and ICOA was the name of this website that decided it was going to run a story that Google had purchased this one big company. And as soon as everyone reported it, including NBC and all the others, they realized it didn't take long that it was just made up. So it's just one of those things nowadays, you don't know what to believe. And heaven help you if you go to Cullman Live and decide to take that at face value, right? Oh, well. In Lansing, Michigan, the mayor's proposing that they go bankrupt because they aren't able to pay their employees. Now, that would be a terrible situation, would it not be? that you have so much outgoing that you don't have much incoming, and as a result, you are going to have to do what? Ask the county to take over your operation? That's what they're considering in Lansing. In San Francisco, people demanding better cell phone service. And, you know, I don't know what it is about the coastal states, but they've got a sort of a strange outlook on things. You know, they want the pie in the sky, it seems like. Look at California, you know. I mean, there are all kinds of regulations there. There are cars the rest of us drive, and then there's the cars that California drives because of emission standards and such. At least that's the way it used to be. But they want better cell phone service, but they don't want to see a tower. Well, you have to admit, it is something of a blight, is it not, that when you're out in the middle of nowhere, maybe the southern part of the county or even the western part, and up there's a cell phone tower, you know, out in the middle of nowhere. In fact, out there in San Francisco, they are putting their cell phone towers inside church steeples, believe it or not, and have them disguised as trees. Now, I wonder what that costs the person who gets Verizon in California, you know, because people don't want to see a cell phone tower. Don't you just wonder sometimes, what's going on? I mean, former President Bill Clinton trying to retire the campaign debt of his wife Hillary a few years back when she ran for president. He's out sending emails asking people to help him pay off this $73,000 that she incurred as a result of this campaign for president. They have to ask us for money. Oh, goodness gracious. And, you know, a speaking event with Bill Clinton, it would seem as though that would be something that would be just paid right up front, you know, at least that much money if you were to go to a big metropolis and such. Smithsonian Magazine has released its pick for the 20 best towns in America. That's going to be in the May issue. I don't know how they got word so soon. It's not going to be there till the May of this year. But Smithsonian says the best one is Great Barrington, Massachusetts, and a town in New Mexico. And yet, there'll be another magazine, undoubtedly. You see this every couple of months. Someone decides they're going to tell you who the best people are or the best location is to retire, places to go, when, and for so many of us, we're happy we're right here. Isn't it interesting that our lifestyle, and there's progress, a lot of progress in Cullman County. This is our choice. And for someone else, though, who maybe comes from a big metropolis or New York, it's much too slow. Some of us just like it slow, do we not? All right. Stay tuned. More of Today on Two after these words.
That's why I shop at Doug Doggett Jewelers.
That's why I shop at Doug Doggett Jewelers.
And that's why I shop at Doug Doggett Jewelers too. Ho, 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 ho.
At Premier Bank, we take pride in serving our community. We respect our customers, and we've won awards for our ethical conduct. We're motivated to do all we can for you, and we're interested in your banking needs. We're efficient, safe, and sound, and our relationships with our customers are second to none.
At Premier Bank, we put the customer first.
Experience winter, the fun, the wonderland of lights that is the Christmas season at Sportsman's Lake Park. Bring your family to see the lights, hear the sounds, and join the fun activities that makes the Christmas season a wonderful experience and a memory for years to come. And Santa will be on hand to take your Christmas list. Brought to you by the Cullman County Parks and Recreation and special partners across Cullman County. Wishing you and your family a merry, merry Christmas.
Time for Cullman to meet Miss Cullman area, Kelsey Richter. Kelsey, thank you so much for making the drive from Birmingham to be with us today.
Well, thank y'all for having me. I'm so excited to be here. Thank you.
Yes. So tell us a little bit about your pageant journey through, because I know that you've competed previously in the Miss Alabama pageant. So tell us a little bit about your journey through Miss Alabama.
Okay. Yes, I have competed in Miss Alabama the past 2 years. Mm-hmm. I first went to Miss Alabama as Miss Samford University, yes. And that was just an absolute blast. It was my first time, so it was just a great experience, and I learned a lot. And then afterwards, I decided this is something that I definitely want to do again. I want to continue in the pursuit of the Miss Alabama crown, and I competed last year as Miss Jefferson County. Mm-hmm. And after the pageant, I was like, okay, one more try. I can do this again. This is my last year to compete. And so I signed up for the Miss Coleman Area Pageant, and I was just blessed to be crowned the winner at the end of the night. So I'm excited about this year and everything that we have the opportunity to do here in Coleman.
Yes, and tell us a little bit about your talent. What do you do when you compete?
Well, I am a vocalist. I've been a singer for many years now. I started singing in my church when I was just a young little girl. And then now I've decided that I really have a passion for Broadway, mm-hmm. and I try to stick with Broadway songs to sing. This past year, I sang What I Did for Love from the musical A Chorus Line. Mm-hmm. And if everything continues to go the way I hope so, then I would like to sing that again this year in the Miss Alabama competition. It's just a song that I've grown to really enjoy performing, and I love singing, so I hope to do that again.
Right. And, of course, everyone would want to know about what your platform is. So tell us a little bit about your platform.
Yes. My platform is hospice, and it's something that is very dear to my heart. My grandfather passed away from cancer when I was in middle school, and hospice came into his home during the very last stages of his life. And through that, they counseled me, and they helped me go through the grieving process. And I knew that that's something I wanted to give back. I wanted to give back to hospice, and I wanted to help younger children as they lose a loved one.
Right.
And I've been able to do that through being a volunteer with hospice. And now I am a nurse at Children's Hospital of Alabama, and I work on a cardiac care unit for children that are waiting for heart transplants. And a lot of these children are terminally ill, so my experience with hospice has given me the ability to be the best nurse that I can possibly be to these children as well.
That is
an amazing platform. So my platform has really just become my career, and
wow.
It's something I'm very, very passionate about.
Wow, that is wonderful, and what a wonderful thing for those children as well that you have that experience. Also, I wanted to know a little bit about what has been your favorite experience from this Miss Alabama journey, because there are so many great memories you make, so many great friends. What's been your favorite part of this whole 3 years that you've competed?
Oh my goodness, well there are just so many different experiences, but I would say that this past year I had the opportunity to go to the Capitol in Montgomery and advocate for my platform of hospice, and I was able to work with some lobbyists there and speak with the governor about my platform, and that was just a really great experience for me. It was me and a few of the other Miss Alabama contestants, and so to spend the day there with them in Montgomery, and really the Miss Alabama organization is so incredible, and the contestants are just simply amazing, and I just feel so challenged by them in a great way to just get out there, and there's so much that we can do and so much that we can advocate for. So being at the Capitol in Montgomery for my platform was a great experience for me.
Right.
Kelsey, let me ask you personal details.
Okay,
We have a lot of Richters live in Coleman. Are you related?
I'm not related, although I've been asked that several times. I had no idea. But no, I'm not related to anyone here in Coleman.
So where are you from originally, Kelsey?
I'm actually originally from South Georgia.
Okay.
And I moved to Alabama about 5.5 years ago. And so now I'm in Alabama. I have my Alabama driver's license.
Oh, good.
I'm an Alabamian now.
So you grew up in Georgia?
I did. I grew up in Georgia, and a lot of my family still lives in Georgia right now.
Okay. And so how was that transition from moving to, did you move for college
moved,
for Samford?
Yes. I moved to go to Samford.
Okay.
So it was a really easy transition for me because Samford was such a great university, and mm-hmm. they made the transition very smooth and very easy. And so once I got to Birmingham, I knew that this is where I wanted to be. Birmingham became my home, and Alabama became my home. And so I'm very proud to call it home now.
Tell us about your Black Friday shopping experience.
Well, my Black Friday shopping experience was, it was crazy, absolutely crazy. I actually was in New York City for Black Friday this year, and I decided to brave Macy's, the largest department store in the world, on Black Friday. And all I could say is I really didn't purchase anything because the lines were way too long. I attempted to find some new boots, but I had to wait for 30 minutes just to even try one pair on. And so I decided, you know what, it's okay, I'm just going to people watch. And so people watch I did. And it, the people, they were bound to get the best deal that they possibly could. And they were not very nice about it. You know, I'm used to these people in the South. They're just very sweet and, oh, honey, this and that. Not the same in New York City. Not at all.
I can only imagine. Oh.
What time did the store open in New York?
They didn't open until 5 a.m., which I know is different. Like here, a lot of the stores are opening at midnight now,
right.
But mm-hmm. in New York, they kept it at 5 a.m. But I thought about going at 5 a.m., then I decided it just wasn't worth it.
Let's go back to the Miss Alabama pageant. This
right.
will be your
third
time.
Third year.
What will you do differently this time?
I think this year, in the past, sometimes when you compete in the system, you can kind of put a lot of pressure on yourself and you, okay, I want to do this and I want to do this and this. But this year, it being my last year, I've decided that I just am going to change my attitude and just let it be fun. And everything I do, I'm going to have the intention to make better relationships with the girls, get to know them better, put more focus on my platform and having fun with my platform. And I think that if I do that and stay in that mindset, then that's going to be the best possible way for me to compete. I think that's what it's all about. Mentally, just knowing that whatever I do, it's all up for the Lord to decide what happens, and just putting your best foot forward and just leaving it all there and having fun with it and enjoying yourself.
And we've been so lucky to have Miss Elizabeth Wesson, who was Miss Coleman area previously.
Yes.
She got into the top 10 at Miss Alabama. And
she did.
And so I think that you are going to be just right behind her in that.
You.
And I think Coleman is just very, very lucky to have someone like you represent
well,
it. I'm
you
very
so
excited.
Much, Paige. I'm excited about it. It's going to be a great year. And I know more and more girls this year, and I know exactly how to handle the Miss Alabama experience, because sometimes it can be a little bit overwhelming.
Yes, yes, it can.
But this year, it's going to be wonderful. I'm truly excited about it. I want to fast forward to June now.
So, yes, when is the Miss Alabama pageant exactly?
It is the first week of June.
Okay.
We'll compete all week. You know, Paige, since you competed, but the first few days, you do practices, and you kind of go out, and you get to wear your crown, and be with all the girls, and it's a lot of fun, because you kind of get to show everybody, hey, this is what we've worked for, and this is what we're about. And then you start competing on Wednesday night, and you do preliminaries, and then the final night of Miss Alabama will be on that Saturday. So the first week of June is full of Miss Alabama activities.
Yes, so everyone go out and support Kelsey.
Thank you.
The thing that I was most shocked about at Miss Alabama, you'll probably laugh, is that I was like, oh my goodness, this was also my first time competing,
uh-huh.
and I said, oh my goodness, I'm not going to be able to eat all week. And then they first night or second night, they took us to Dreamland Barbecue.
Oh, yeah. I had a rib eating competition, and you're like, people think that the girls like don't eat all week. That
no,
is
we eat so
you
much.
Eat ribs. They have donuts every night afterwards, Chick-fil-A sandwiches. So you kind of just have to work hard up until the week, and then that week you're just you don't worry about it. There's no need,
and you're doing so much physically that
oh,
week,
I know.
Anyways.
Exactly.
That it kind of works itself out. But I was shocked when I got there. I was like, oh my goodness, there's so much food.
And the funniest thing though is after swimsuit, the girls that they there's a food table backstage
every night,
yeah. And the girls just sprint to the food table after swimsuit competition, and they'll still be in their swimsuits, and they have like a donut in one hand, chicken fingers in the other. It's hysterical. It's probably my favorite thing to watch.
And it was so refreshing to know that this is not just like girls be in a pageant like you would see
no.
on TV or something like that.
It is not the same. Not
no.
the same at
there
all.
There are some very
it's so
genuine
much more
people.
Than that. Yes, yes, very much so. There's a lot more than that. Every girl has a heart for their platform, mm-hmm. and they're passionate about everything that they do, and every girl is so incredibly talented, and they really do just challenge you. And so, yes, it's definitely so much more that you see on TV or so much more than people initially think.
And something that's so great about the Miss America, Miss Alabama system is that they offer such good role models, because these are real down-to-earth girls who are just have been through some hard times
exactly.
and have great platforms. Just excellent things for young girls.
I agree completely.
Yes.
Completely.
Let me ask you an inside question.
Okay.
This is just between us. We
okay.
won't let anybody else in on this. You talk about the friends that you meet
yes.
and you know so many of the contestants. Is there one or two contestants that nobody likes?
I wouldn't say that that nobody likes them. But there's often contestants that you know, like, okay, maybe I just won't hang out with them all the time because they might bring me down. And that's the kind of thing that you just have to look out for. But honestly, there's not many of those contestants at all, which I know is shocking to people. My boyfriend told me one time, he was like, I can't believe y'all are all friends. Mm-hmm. And I was like, but we are. Like, why wouldn't we be? We all enjoy the same type of activities. We really feel the same way about many different things. And why wouldn't we be friends? So, yeah, there's often a few that maybe just try to bring you down, but you just don't hang out with them the whole time. And you just hang out with the girls that bring you up.
What will you be doing to prepare for Miss Alabama this summer?
Well, it's going to be, it's just initially, you have to kind of start out and realize, you have to make a game plan for yourself. Okay, what do I want to do this year as I prepare for Miss Alabama? And for me, it's just going to be working on my interview. Things like this really just help prepare you for interview, just being more comfortable speaking in front of people. And so it'll be working on my interview, working on my talent and preparing for it and making it the best that it possibly can be. I'll be working with a talent coach to make sure that my talent is right where it needs to be come June. And then just staying in physical good shape. I think it's important for us to have healthy lifestyles as contestants. And so making sure I stay in good shape. And then also just really getting to know my director, which is Tanya Hall, and as she helps me prepare for the competition. I think that's so important. And then, of course, throughout the year, I'll be promoting my platform of hospice and the national platform for the Miss America organization, which is Children's Miracle Network, which being a nurse at Children's Hospital, I have the opportunity to do that daily.
Right. Which part of the competition do you enjoy the most?
I would say interview, just because I like to talk to people. An interview's fun for me because you have 10 minutes to be with the judges and just tell them about your heart and let them know everything that you want them to hear in those 10 minutes. And I think that interview is also one of the most important competitions. Yes. Because it sets us apart from any other pageant organization in the country. Interview is so important for the Miss America competition. You want scholarly girls, girls that are passionate about their platforms, passionate about the community, and you can really see that in an interview.
And which is the most difficult for you?
Honestly, I don't like on-stage question because you never know what they're going to ask you. They could ask you something just completely random, and then you have to answer the question in front of thousands of people. And what if you just don't say exactly what you mean to say? So I try to just, if I can make it through your on-stage question, then I'm good.
Well, we congratulate you. You
well,
will be a great
so
representative
much.
For Miss Coleman area.
Thank
and
you.
And wish you well this summer.
Thank you.
Thank you,
y'all, for having me here today.
Thank you
I
so
really
much.
Enjoyed it.
We'll have more of Today on 2 right after this.
At Premier Bank, we are very proud of the long-lasting relationships we have with our customers. We'll go almost anywhere to meet your banking needs.
Overwhelmed by home refinancing offers from telephone solicitors and direct mail advertising, and then find you're not qualified for a specific plan? The Mortgage Center, a hometown lender, compares the rates from all home loan lenders and the qualifications of the various government programs to find a plan best suited to you. The Mortgage Center helps Cullman County people purchase and refinance their homes.
This is Pat Moody. Call us today and let us tailor a loan program to your specific needs and requirements.
Meet the KitchenAid 36-inch induction cooktop. It might just change the way you cook. Induction technology heats the pan and not the cooking surface to offer you a new level of precision, speed, and energy efficiency. 9 settings give you different levels of heat to achieve precise temperatures and amazing responsiveness. Water boils in just seconds, making this the fastest to boil induction cooktop available. The KitchenAid 36-inch induction cooktop.
Yeah, we're all here. If you saw what was going on here during the commercial break, Paige and Kelsey were having a picture taken, and
yes.
The director's yelling at us, we're coming back.
Yes, they have
you
those Miss Alabama scrapbooks that they have to complete. So this can go in her Miss Alabama scrapbook. We're so glad.
I noticed that you didn't ask me to be in the picture.
I'm sorry, Dennis.
Mm-hmm.
Did we hurt your feelings?
I feel slighted. It is time to give away our prizes for today. Let's see what we have on this Thursday. We have coffee from Gelato Joe's in the Warehouse District. And we also have KSW Colored Salt, which is also available at Gelato Joe's, and a bag of assorted apples from Steel Orchard. Those are the prizes we have. Let's look at some of our merchant ads. We'll ask a question, of course, about one of these ads. Starting with High Tide Sports Grill, they're now open Tuesday through Saturday. Happy hour every day from 5 until 7 o'clock. That's High Tide Sports Grill.
And Hansville Guns and Ammo, they have lower prices on guns, ammo, and reloading supplies. Their shelves are fully stocked right now, and they have a special on the AR-15 tactical rifle. Save almost $200 on the corner across from Hansville City Hall.
Open the door to history and fine prints. This is Renard's Gallery and Gift, an art gallery, a gift store, a jewelry store. Custom framing is available, located on First Avenue Southeast.
And Cosmic Sound, with over 26 years of DJ entertainment experience, they are your wedding DJ specialists. Call DJ Big D or DJ Wild Bill, or visit them at cosmicsound.net.
And Baldwin Counseling Center, help is a phone call away. Call Dr. Howard Rogers at Baldwin Counseling Center, solving problems one at a time.
Mullins Body Shop on Highway 31 South at Thielen. You've counted on them for 52 years for auto body repair and towing. You can count on them today. Call Sunny, Stacy, Beth, or Jim at Mullins Body Shop.
The difference is not when you open our bottle, it's when you open our door. This is Borden Family Pharmacy, located on Highway 157 at Good Neighbor Pharmacy.
The Coleman Wellness and Aquatic Center has fitness opportunities available. They have a 6-lane competition pool, a full fitness center, a variety of aerobic and cycling classes. Day passes are available for just $10.
And sweet deals available at Dairy Queen. Pick any four of these 9 items, pay just $5.55. The Mini Blizzard Meal Deal, you get a sandwich, a Blizzard, fries, and a Coke for just $5. And those are some of the merchant ads. Our phone number, 256-734-7399. One of our advertisers has a product called the MyEbo Tablet.
Yes.
Tell us which advertiser is selling this product. What it is, it's a Christian tablet, electronic tablet.
You just gave a big hint away.
Yes, I think I did too. The MyEbo Tablet is available at which one of our advertisers? First person with the correct answer received coffee from Gelato Joe's, KSW Colored Salt, and the bag of assorted apples from Steel Orchard. And we have a caller. Hello, who's calling? From where are you calling?
Coleman.
From Coleman, okay. Who has the MyEbo tablet?
The Christian Bookstore.
Yes, that's right, H. Chance Christian Bookstore. Stay on the line, please. Thanks for calling in. They have that. It is a Christian tablet.
That's right.
Does a lot of neat things. We're going to talk about that. The ad will be coming up here in just a moment. Let's look at the rest of our ads right now. Starting on Tires for Less, more than just tires. They can do minor engine repair, of course, oil changes, shocks and brakes. And you mentioned this ad that you saw it on Channel 2. You get $5 off an oil change.
And the tutor doctor worried about grades. They make house calls. They give personalized one-on-one tutoring. And they have convenient, flexible hours. Give Carla Brower a call at 734-6500, the Tutor Doctor.
The crew at Earl's Body Shop reminds you, move over for emergency vehicles. Earl's Body Shop, of course, located on Highway 31 North, offering 24-hour wrecker service as well as auto body repair.
Yates Chance Christian Bookstore, it's here. A better way to shop for Christian entertainment is the MyEbo Color Tablet. You can browse, search, discover, and buy song downloads, ebooks, video games, Bible software, and more. Their Christmas open house is December 1st.
People's Tires Brake and Alignment Center, special for today, Thursday, $3 off an oil change. Anybody and everybody can save $3 on an oil change today at People's Tires.
And Deb's Bookstore is your hometown bookstore just down the road. Used books are half price every day, and new books are 20% off every day. Browsers are welcome, and gift certificates are available at Deb's Bookstore.
Mr. Hicks Menswear, men's suits and sport coats in regular big and tall sizes. Mr. Hicks Menswear on Compass Way Southwest in Coleman. The Reader's Choice Award winner for men's clothing.
What does happy look like? Step out in style with Allegria Shoes at the Uniform Place. They have houndstooth, hippie chic, even piece black. Go and visit them today.
Those are the merchant ads we have for today. Now let's check our birthdays for the 29th of November.
Yes, on this Thursday, Danny Miller, Kate Kreider, Norman Kreider, and Eula Lyons celebrate a birthday.
I would like to especially acknowledge Eula Lyons. This is Kim's mother, and she is 90 today.
Wow.
Happy birthday, Eula.
And they will go in our drawing on Friday to win an 8x10 portrait from Baker Photography and an ice cream cake from Dairy Queen.
Our weather forecast brought to you by Mitch Smith Chevrolet on Cherokee Avenue. Make the switch to Mitch. Sunny today, a high of 61. Clear tonight, low of 37. Sunny again tomorrow with a high of 61.
There's stuff around your house, but we don't make stuff. We make ovens. Dual fuel, double ovens. And they bake so evenly that now delicious is something you can depend on. We only make things for one room. The best room. Your kitchen. We're devoted to it. And you can feel it in everything we make. Nobody knows the kitchen like KitchenAid.
Overwhelmed by home refinancing offers from telephone solicitors and direct mail advertising, and then find you're not qualified for a specific plan? The Mortgage Center, a hometown lender, compares the rates from all home loan lenders and the qualifications of the various government programs to find a plan best suited to you. The Mortgage Center helps Cullman County people purchase and refinance their homes.
This is Pat Moody. Call us today and let us tailor a loan program to your specific needs and requirements.
You don't know where to go to. Why don't you go where fashion sits? Putting on the Ritz. Different types who wear a day coat, pants with stripes and cutaway coat, perfect fit.
That's why I shop at Doug Dog at Jewelry.
Putting on the Ritz.
Another round for the house.
Yeah. Target, ma'am.
Prove it.
Oh, night's still young. Saloon's sure crowded tonight.
When the ranchers come alone, it's a saloon. When they bring their wives, it's a social hall.
You got a point. Here. Buy yourself a drink.
Drink? Mister, this goes in the bank.
Born down around the old panhandle, Texas is where he grew to fame. There ain't a horse that he can't handle. That's how he got his name. Bronco, Bronco, tearing across the Texas plain. Bronco, Bronco, Bronco Lane.
Let's talk about Christmas.
Yes.
What do you say? The Christmas parade at Hanceville is coming up on Saturday. Sally Alexander is here once again to talk about the parade. And Herman Reed is here also. And Herman is the Grand Marshal this year. Congratulations, Herman.
Thank you. It's an honor.
You have been a member of the Civitan Club for how many years now?
58 in Cullman and about 12 or 13 in Hanceville.
Wow. Congratulations, Herman. Give us a little background about the Civitan Club, especially the Cullman Club you've been in for so many years.
Well, the Cullman Club was organized in 1954 over at this, well, we call it the West Methodist Church over there at St. Andrews now. And Brother Sammy Stabler was our first president. And I became a member there. And, of course, it's changed around, and we've met all over Cullman and as far as that goes. But it's the only international civic club is south of the Mason-Dixon line. The rest of them are north, and we have the headquarters in Birmingham. And so we are real proud of that, the fact that our international headquarters is south of the Mason-Dixon line. Mm-hmm. Not that we are prejudiced about anything like that, but we're proud. But that's one of the great things. And we are builders of good citizens. We try to make the high school kids, we give them a good citizenship pin every year, a boy and a girl. The faculty and several of the clubs will select these two individuals. They don't know it until they get ready to get the pin that day and at the exercise of giving out awards. And we try to stress the fact that to be a good citizen, honest and upright, and live to be an example for other people. And so we give those pins away, and then, of course, we help with the Margaret Jean Jones Center down here. And we've helped a lot of people, and we've built a park down there. I don't mean to be bragging, but I'm glad that they've named that park after me. So after 50-something years, I guess you're entitled to something like that. But we are real proud of the fact that those instructors and people down there at the center can take a person that's got a little bit of of ability to learn, a disabled person, and they can teach them a trade. Now, they fix boxes. They take boxes that are flattened out, then they fix them into where they can be used to put material in them. And some of those people down there can become a real professional and a real pro with that little thing. That's one little thing they can do. And it brings them a little income, gives them something to do, security and all that kind of stuff. So it's something that we've had people that come down there and couldn't dress themselves, couldn't do hardly anything except just get up.
Right.
And some of them couldn't hardly get up. And now they're in group homes, living a life of their own and becoming a good citizen of our country because of the fact that somebody cares. Mm-hmm. And that's what we're trying to do, is to be a good citizen, and because we care. And you talk about disabled people and children, you get up close to me, because that's one of my pet things. I've been doing this for about 50 years, you know, and so it's enjoyable. And your reward is what you see, the results of what comes of that individual development and how he maintains himself and improves himself and become a real citizen. You know?
Sally, let's talk about the parade.
Well, the parade will start promptly at 2 o'clock Saturday, this Saturday. We will line up on College Road Drive there at Wallace College, like always. There's no entry fee. If you have a business that you want to promote, just put your signs on the side of your vehicle and come down there and show up, and we're going to put you in line. They will actually tell you when you pull in there to College Road Drive which area you need to be in based on which category you're going to be in. But we just welcome everyone to come out, and Coleman County just comes together really well for this. Every year it just gets bigger and bigger. And we don't even know how many people we will have this Saturday, but we're anticipating it to be bigger than it was last year. I think last year we had 67 entries. And one thing I'd like to say about Civitan International, that another thing that we do as a whole, as a service organization, all of the clubs, we funnel our funding, a lot of it, to the Center, the Civitan International Research Foundation in Birmingham. And that research center in Birmingham does cutting-edge research on spinal cord injuries and also developmental disabilities that are caused from the brain. And they are doing some fantastic things with restoring people's ability to recover from being paralyzed from the waist down, and restoring them to an active lifestyle. So it's going to, you know, who knows what we'll see in the next 5 to 10 years with the research that's going on down there. And it's right here in Alabama. Mm-hmm. It's being done right here in Birmingham. And like Herman said, it's just fantastic to have such great things going on right here in Alabama.
And we're just about this close to getting to the gene that causes this disabling.
Really?
And so they're really good, and they're working on it. Civitan has pledged $1 million a year for, 20 years, I think. We're already into that system for a long time for the research. And so it's great. And if you ever been in a swimming when you was a kid and got a leech on your foot or your toe like that, that's some of the little animals that they use in their research. It's got a lot of nerve systems like the humans and all. And they're just about that close to getting to the gene that causes this. And if they ever can, then we are real successful.
It'll be amazing what will be prevented and the lives that will be enriched and restored from the work that's being done down there at our research foundation. But about the parade Saturday, we just welcome everyone to come out and get in line. And we're just going to have a great time with it like we always do. Everyone that's participated in the past, well, we anticipate them to be back again this year. So we're really looking forward to having a great parade.
We do something for the nursing home down there. We make a loop into their drive when they're front, and they get out on the front, and they have a ball watching the parade go by.
Yes.
And we just enjoy doing it, and it makes us feel good, and we're making them feel good.
Yeah, you get a tremendous blessing out of it. You really do.
for people who have never been to the parade in Hanceville, what is the route of the parade?
The route starts there at College Drive. Mm-hmm. We turn right onto Highway 31, go south into Hanceville, and it'll end right there just past City Hall on 31.
Okay. And I understand that people do not need to register entries ahead of time, just show up, right?
No, just show up. Just come out and be with us and be part of this. And it's just a wonderful fellowship and socializing event to celebrate Christmas. This year's theme is God Bless America Again. And we just want to build that feeling of what the season is all about, that it's all about the birth of Christ, and celebrate that.
And the weather forecast is wonderful for
yes.
Saturday, because you've had some cold years.
Yes, we certainly have.
Ones too.
Yes, we certainly have. And this year, it just looks like we're going to have the most perfect day for the parade. It's going to be close to 70,
mm-hmm.
and it's just supposed to be beautiful and sunny.
Have you in past years gotten rained out and had to postpone or not?
Very few. Maybe, yeah, maybe.
Two or three times.
But
yeah.
This is our 21st annual. So,
wow.
You know, considering how many times we've had this parade,
uh-huh.
we've not been rained out very many times.
Uh-huh. Do you get a good turnout of high school bands from the county?
Yes, we do. Almost all of them except Coleman City. We wish that they would participate also because mm-hmm. they're such a fantastic band.
Right.
But all the other bands in the county come and they participate almost every single year. They're there. And they get $500 for participating.
Good.
Mm-hmm. So they do get something, you know, it helps the bands too.
Mm-hmm.
We have sponsors that help us with that, make a contribution
yes.
to it. And through that, we can make it worthwhile for them to come, and it's an extra practice for them, really.
Sure. Mm-hmm.
And it gives them an extra opportunity to show themselves. And those bands really show out, and they really strut when they go down through that.
They do.
Well, they'll enjoy the fact that it's going to be a nice day also.
Oh, yes, they will.
I think we have one of the best creeds that any club could ever have. It's the closest thing to being a Bible club than anything else. Of course, we talk about our heart, head, hands, and feet all the way through the whole system of our body
yeah.
being a service to our country and to our people. And so the Civitan Creed to me is what got me in Civitan.
It is for me too.
I said, when I heard that, what can I do to be a part of that? And I've tried to be a part of it for these years.
About how many members are in each club?
Well, it depends. Well, we have 40-something. I mean, Coleman has 40-something. We have about 12 or 15. Now, we're on the low end.
Mm-hmm.
We've changed places to meet, and our places to meet went out of business. So we've had to meet around different places. It kind of loses interest, but we're on the growth.
Mm-hmm.
And we have clubs and all over the world.
Mm-hmm.
And they have a Civitan International Convention scattered all over the world, even overseas and everywhere else. So if you're Civitan-minded and want to go on trips, you get a good opportunity. And boy, you meet some of the greatest people in the world.
You really do.
When and where does the Coleman Club meet and then the Hanceville? You said Hanceville's kind of on the go.
We meet down at Daly's now. And Hanceville is meeting at Luna, what is it?
We're meeting at Lupe's Restaurant.
Lupe's, yeah.
The
okay.
second and third Tuesday of the month.
Third Tuesday?
At 2 o'clock in the afternoon.
Okay. Okay, and when
and
again?
Coleman meets at the first, second, and fourth Tuesdays at 6 o'clock down at Daly's.
Okay,
yeah.
Okay, very good. Well, Sally, give us a quick rundown again, where and when for the parade.
Okay, Saturday, if you want to be in the parade, be there between 1 and 1:30. We will put you in line, and at 2 o'clock, the parade will promptly begin.
Very good. Thank you for being, Sally, good to have you back on the program.
Good
Herman,
here.
Good to see you again. It's been
good
a while since I've talked to you.
I always love to come visit with you.
We'll have more of Today on 2 right after this.
There's something about the moment when you first walk into that new home. It took a lot to get there, but Eva Bank made it easy to get the loan you needed. Eva Bank, as a part of the community, makes lending decisions right here where you live. Our lenders make the process quick and easy with rates you'll love. Visit your neighbors at Eva Bank today and let them help you with your new home loan, manufactured home, refinance, or remodel. Eva Bank, part of the community we call home.
Life lived in black and white is not a life lived. Today, I choose color. To see it. To feel it. to be in it, to be upon it, and to live a life surrounded by it. Today, I put on a fresh coat.
At Premier Bank, we're a bit old-fashioned. We actually answer the telephone when you call. However, old-fashioned doesn't mean we aren't up to date. With the latest technology, Premier Bank meets the various needs of our customers. Mobile smartphone banking, internet banking, ATMs, convenient offices. At Premier Bank, we have the right products right now with good old-fashioned customer service. At Premier Bank, we put the customer first.
Do what's done.
Our community billboards are brought to you by Pepsi and Coleman Jefferson Gas. A Christmas Carol CHS Spectacular will be November 30th and December 1st at 7 p.m. in the CHS Auditorium. Students and children's tickets are $5. Students and children are $3. Bring the family out for Coleman's official Christmas tree lighting ceremony at Depot Park. This is Thursday, December the 6th, from 5:30 to 6:30, entertained by the Wall State Singers and other bands in the area, and pictures with Santa, fun for the whole family. And the annual Christmas Arts and Crafts Show at the Coleman Civic Center will be Friday, December 7th and Saturday, December 8th from 9 to 5 each day. Come shop and find the perfect something for someone on your Christmas list. It's free admission. Faith Baptist Church presents The Story Goes On, a world premiere musical on Saturday, December 8th at 7, Sunday, December 9th at 11 and 7. For more information, you can contact the church office at 734-7307. And the annual Christmas Winter Wonder Light Show will be lit up again this year at Sportsman's Lake Park from 5 p.m. to 9 p.m. each night through December the 23rd. Santa Claus will be available for visits, and carriage rides are also on tap. The fee is $5 per car and $10 per bus. Our community billboards are brought to you by Pepsi and Coleman Jefferson Gas. If your organization has a billboard they'd like to send to us, email it to channel2coleman@gmail.com, fax it to 734-7680, or friend us on Facebook, Channel 2 Coleman.
The weather forecast for today, a beautiful day in store. Sunny today, a high of 61, clear tonight, low of 37. More of the same tomorrow, sunny with a high of 61. And tomorrow, Friday on Today on 2, who's our guest?
Tomorrow we'll have Corey Harbison as our guest for That's Politics.
Corey Harbison, the mayor of Good Hope, will be with us tomorrow. Thank you for watching Today on 2.
Hope you have a great day.